When dozens of people send me links to the same video with a title like An Open Letter to Atheists from a Priest, there are two possibilities. One is that they want to hear my response to whatever argument or argument-let that that video is presenting, and the other is that they're really hoping I can tell the priest in question how hard they can go fuck themselves. And I'm going to be honest, I'm not sure where the video everybody sent me this week falls. So this video comes from a Franciscan priest named Casey Cole, and he starts with the question, are you a good atheist? And I'm like, you know, I don't provide money or support for the world's largest child rape cabal, so I'm already better than the best Catholic, aren't I? I mean, seriously, like, where does this arrogant prick get off acting like he gets to decide where the bar for goodness belongs for atheists? I mean, that would be true even if you set aside the fact that he's dedicated his life to a group that's presently harboring child rapists, and I have no idea why you would set that aside. So he goes on to split that question about goodness into two sections. The first is the are you a moral person question. Now, again, I feel like the guy who swears fealty to a book that marks out an acceptable level of beating one's slaves doesn't really get a say in issues of morality, but he's going to opine anyway. He admits that Christianity, quote, doesn't necessarily make a person moral, end quote. And I'm like, what the fuck is necessarily doing there? Christianity doesn't make people moral. There, I fixed it. In fact, if numbers are to be believed, and you guys seem to think three is one, so who the fuck knows, Christianity actually makes people less moral if we judge morality by, you know, likelihood of doing immoral shit like beating your kids or murdering people. Of course, he admits that Christians fall short on their agreed upon moral code, but he fails to admit that it's when they do shit like wear mixed fabrics or suffer a witch to live. His point, though, is that Christians have a moral structure and we poor atheists don't. Other than, you know, the cultural moral standards that everyone, including Christians, use regardless of their religion. It's the one that tells them that, you know, mixed fabrics and which non-killing prohibitions in their book can be ignored, for example. And there's also the law, right? That also is there. And of course, that wouldn't even exist if religion actually did the shit that he's claiming it does. But all of that shit is just a warm up for the main thrust of the video, which is an argument best summarized as, yes, but have you read everything ever written about Christianity? And if not, how do you even know what you're rejecting? Apparently their fruits aren't enough all of a sudden. So he opens this section with this little gem, quote, can you articulate why you don't believe in God in a coherent way? Or do you just say religion is dumb and use logical fallacies, end quote? Because, you know, how else are those horses going to push that cart all the way to the market? Motherfucker, you can't even define your God in a coherent way. I'm supposed to argue against it coherently? Jesus. He goes on to ask, quote, have you read the works of real theologians? People are articulating our beliefs in the absolute best way we know how? Or do you stick with the simplicity of the evangelical pastors from some rural anti-intellectual church? End quote. Because apparently we're supposed to do more research on this fucking religion than the people who adhere to it. Look, that ain't how this shit works, man. How many books about Jainism did you read before you rejected that? How many of the top Sasquatch researchers did you familiarize yourself with before you rejected Bigfoot? How many asylum wall poop scrawlings did you peruse before you decided that Count Chocula wasn't coming to kill us all? There are some ideas that are too stupid to merit a deep dive, Casey, and the universe was made by an omnipotent menage a trois that loves me very much is so much stupider than concerns about a genocidal serial mascot, okay? Besides, y'all have been trying to prove God's existence since the beginning of formalized fucking thought, okay? I mean, if you'd come up with a good argument by now, nobody'd have to go digging for it in the obscure works of some theologian I've never heard of. You guys would never shut the fuck up about it. In fact, that's what you'd be making a video about instead of this desperate, I deserve to be taken seriously even though I'm dressed like a Jawa's Tinder profile argument that you have going now. At one point, he says, all I'm asking is that you read more perspectives, but that's not what he's asking at all. He's asking that we read his perspective, right? Notice how he doesn't explain how we're going to rule out the beliefs of the Oyoreo people of Paraguay, after all. You know, there are a functionally infinite number of worldviews, and if your only metric is at least as plausible as Catholicism, you would have to read literally millions of books before you could settle on any one worldview. or even prefer one. And what's so amazing to me about this whole fucking video is that he honestly thinks that it's a reasonable request. I mean, all he's asking for is intellectual do-overs times infinity. All he's asking for is for you to construct an argument on his behalf and then mull it over. All he's asking is that you pretend there are serious questions about this stuff, even if you know there aren't. So here's a response to your open letter, Casey, and it's all the response your bullshit deserves. Dear Casey, go fuck yourself. P.S. Very hard.